Wish all the students of class 3 a very good morning. Today I will explain you your English literature chapter 5, Something Unexpected Happens part 2. In the previous chapter, chapter 4, we have already learned about the characters over there. This is a story from or about Heidi, who is a little village girl, and she was staying with her grandfather and Peter and her friend Clara. So the story chapter 4 ends with the note that grandfather was quite adamant to take the children up the mountain as it was planned, no matter Clara's wheelchair broke, but grandfather will take the children up the mountain. Now let us continue with chapter 5. What happens after that? So as you can see over here, go to page number 61. In the previous chapter, Peter pushed Clara's wheelchair down the hill, and after that what happened? Clara's wheelchair broke into pieces. Grandfather decided to take Clara and Heidi up the mountain. Now we don't know, will something unexpected happen after this or not? So let us start the chapter in order to know in details. When they reached the spot where the goats usually pastured, they were surprised to find them already feeding there, and Peter with them. "Have you seen the cheer?" asked grandfather. "What cheer?" called Peter. Now when Peter was already there, when grandfather saw Peter and the goats over there and the wheelchair was vanished, so naturally grandfather asked Peter whether he knows about the wheelchair or not. But Peter cleverly answered that as if, or pretended as if, he doesn't know anything about the wheelchair. Grandfather said no more. He spread the shawls on the sunny slope and placed Clara on them. "Oh, Heidi, it is lovely, it is lovely," Clara cried, looking round her. The sky was dark blue and not a single cloud was to be seen. Heidi wanted to go to the spot where the flowers grew to see if they were as lovely as before. Clara was happy sitting all alone on the mountainside. Heidi reached her field of flowers. There she saw lots of shining yellow citrus flower among many others. She turned round and ran to Clara's side, out of breath. "Oh, you must come," she said excitedly. "It is more beautiful than you can imagine. I can help you walk." Clara looked at her and shook her head. "Heidi, you are smaller than I am. Oh, if only I could walk." Now, as Clara's wheelchair was broken and she was unable to walk by herself, so she was sitting on one place, but Heidi was too excited to show Clara the surrounding, the beautiful natural view of the flowers and the meadows. So Heidi came running to Clara and asked her to help us to stand up and walk with her help, so that Clara also can see the view. Heidi looked round and saw Peter sitting up above, looking down at them. Heidi called out, "Peter, come down here." Heidi told Peter to hold Clara under the arm on one side, and she would hold her on the other. Together they were to lift her up, but Clara could not even stand, and Heidi was too small for her to lean upon. "You must put one arm around my neck and the other through Peter's," said Heidi. Peter helped them, but it was still difficult. Clara was up one side and down the other, because her supports were of different heights. Peter was little bit taller than Heidi, and Heidi was shorter than Peter. So as a result, Clara was standing in a difficult position, one side up and one side down. Put your foot down firmly, one suggested Heidi. I am sure it will hurt you less after that. Do you think so? Said Clara hesitantly. She followed Heidi's advice and put one step on the ground and then another. Oh, that was less painful, she exclaimed joyfully. Try again, said Heidi. And Clara went on putting one foot after another until all at once she called out, I can do it, Heidi. Look, look, I can take proper steps. A delighted Heidi shouted, you can walk now, Clara. You can walk. Clara felt stronger with every step and Heidi was filled with happiness. Now you will be able to walk about as I do. It is a great joy. Clara heartily agreed. She could think of no greater joy in the world than to be strong and able to walk like other people. So this was your story. It is a small story, a small part of Heidi's life. And this story is adapted from the main story, Heidi. So if a question will be given to you that from where this story has been adapted, you have to say Heidi. I hope all of you have understood the chapter. You will go through the chapter. You will read the chapter 2 to 3 times in order to understand it better.